So the next concept that we are going to discuss is operators. So we can combine atoms with operators. So different combinations of operator are, we have sequence, alternation, repetition, group and save. So below you have the syntax, how we are going to write. For sequence, it will be nothing. So alternation, we have a pipe symbol. Then repetition, we are going to see it in a flower brackets. Group, we are going to have it as a dot. And save, we have the round brackets and the expression. So let us start with an example of a sequence operator. So what is a sequence operator? So a sequence operator is nothing. What do you mean by that? This means that if a sequence of atoms are shown in a regular expression, it is implied that there is an invisible sequence operator between them. For example, I just mentioned a expression DOG. What does it do? It matches the pattern dog in a given string. So DOG should be a part of that string. So all the three characters in a given expression will be matched with the three characters which are specified and compared in a given string. Then we have A dot dot B. What does it tell? It matches A with any two characters and B. So what does it say? Matches A comma any two characters and B. So A and B is going to be matched, and apart from that, there will be any other two characters between A and B. Okay, so A and B should be there, but apart from that, dot dot indicate that there can be any two characters between A and B. So that is also going to be matched. The second is example that you can see is a regular expression, that is in square bracket 2-4. Complete, we are closing the square bracket, and in the other square bracket you have 0 to 9. So what does it do? Matches a number between 20 and 49. So what does it say? It matches the number between 20, that is 2 and 0, and 4 and 9. Okay, so that is what it is. Practically we'll see what exactly we mean by that. So let us focus on understanding this. So here we have the another expression. In square bracket we have 0 to 9, and in another square bracket again we have 0 to 9. It matches any of the two digits. Okay, it matches any of the two digits. So next one is exceptional operator with a dollar symbol, that is match a blank line. So what does it do? If I use this pattern in my regular expression, what it is going to do? It matches a blank line. Apart from that, we have a exceptional operator with a dot operator and a dollar symbol. What does it do? It matches a one character line. What does it do? It matches a one character line. Fine. So apart from that, you have the last regular expression pattern, that is 0 to 9 hyphen, again in square bracket 0 to 9. What does it do? Matches two digits separated by a hyphen. It is going to do what? It matches two digits separated by a hyphen. So two digits, it may be 1 and 2. So if we have two digits, 1 and 2, these two digits should be separated by a hyphen. Okay, so 10 to 20. So 10 and 20, these are the two digits, and these two digits will be matched if they are separated by a hyphen. Okay, sometimes we give the range, right? Range is 60 to 80. So it will match 60 to 80 with a hyphen. So if we want to match such pattern in a given string, we have to write a regular expression in the form that we have specified. Okay, so apart from that, the next part what we are going to study is evaluation of a string using a sequence operator. So let us take an example. So student, let us take an example of evaluating of a string using sequence operator. So in this example, you can see we have a string called as character, character. Okay. And in a given regular expression, we have given a pattern ACT. So here we are going to check whether the pattern ACT is present in a given string character. Okay, so we are going to match each of the character in a given pattern ACT along with the characters that are given in a string. And if the match is found, we return a result as true. If the match doesn't found, we return the result as false. So here individual characters are going to match of the pattern in the given string. And if the pattern ACT is present in a given character string, then the result is true. So if you look here, I am going to match the pattern ACT, and the string that we have taken here is, for example, is character. So the first character A is matched with the character C in a given string. So as A doesn't match with C, the result is false. And then we move ahead to compare the other character in a given string. Now A is going to be matched with H. So here you can see still we do not get a match and the result is false. Third comparison, you can see A is matching with A. That is the third character in a given string. So after successfully matching the first character of the pattern with the character in a string, we move on to compare the next character. That is the pattern C is matched with R. So here you can see, even though the first character has been matched, the second character is not matching. So C is not matching with R. So we get a result false. So we go on to match with the next character. Now next character is A is matched with R. So as A is not matching with the character R, so the result is false. Then in the fifth match, you can find that A is next character to be matched is A. So the pattern has A, so AA matching happens. Then we move on to match the second character present after A, that is C. So here you can see after A matching, C is also matching. And then we go on to match with the next character present after C, that is T. So here you can see that the pattern ACT is a part of the given string character. Okay, so you can see there ACT is matching and we get the result as true. So this is how the sequence operator works for matching of a given pattern in a regular expression with the given string. Okay, so this we will be demonstrating later. You can practice those commands and you can see there are different operators, different commands that you can type and practice. Now let us move on to the next operator, that is the alternation operator. So what does the alternation operator do? The alternation operator is used to define one or more alternatives. So it will give you an alternative option to be selected from a part of a given string. Now the alternation operator, as I told you, is defined to match one or more alternatives. In the example, you can see I have the word Unix, which is written in capital and followed by a pipe symbol. And there is another word Unix, which is written in lowercase. So what will happen when I use a pipe symbol? It works as an alternation operator. And here it matches Unix or capital Unix or lowercase Unix in a given string. So in a line, if you have mentioned Unix as capital or Unix as a small, lowercase, it will match either of the one. Suppose you have, and the other example, you can see there are three alternative options that you have to match. That is MS, MIS or MRS. So it matches either of the three patterns that are present in a given regular expression. This is how your alternation operator works. The next one what you have is your matching alternation operators. So here in the regular expression, I have given two patterns, FE followed by a pipe symbol and EL. So the regular expression tries to match either FE or EL. So the pattern FE or EL should be a part of a given string. That is what we are going to match. So the given string is hello, and in that hello, we are going to check whether FE or EL is present. So first we are going to check FE. So it checks FE. FE is matched with HE. You can see both are not matching. Next we match FE with EL. It's not matching. Similarly, we match FE with LO. So if you see, there is no match found for FE. Now we move on to find out the other option that we have given, that is EL. Now we match EL with HE. There is no match found. Next, we match EL with the next two characters present in the given string, EL. We find a match and the function returns a true value. This is how the matching alternation operator works. Fine, the next operator that you have is your repetition operator. Now, what is the repetition operator? The repetition operator specifies that the atom or expression immediately before the repetition may be repeated. Okay, so here you have two values, M and N, to be passed, where M is a minimum number of repetitions and N is a maximum number of repetition. So the syntax of the repetition is as shown. You can see a backslash operator followed by a curly braces, and then we have going to pass the two values M comma N, and then the backslash operator followed by a curly braces, closing curly braces. Okay, now here what happens, I have given a pattern A. Now here what does it tells that A should be matched minimum three times or maximum of five times. So in a given pattern, okay, A should be repeated for minimum three times or at for the maximum of five times. Okay, so if I have a pattern where the A is repeated two times, it is not going to be matched. But in a given string, if A is repeatedly coming three times, then it is going to be matched 3, 4, and 5 times. If A is repeatedly appearing in a given string for 6 times, it is not going to be matched, because I have specified the minimum number as 3 and maximum matching number as 5. So in this example, you can see this pattern, what I have given, matches A 3 times, 4 times or 5 times, not beyond that, because I have specified the matching pattern. Next example, you can see BA is the pattern what I have given. As I told you, immediately before the pattern what I have given. Now here B is going to remain constant, but the last atom or the expression immediately before the repetition has to be repeated. Now here what you can say, A. So A is to be repeated how many times? 3 times and 5 times. B is going to appear only once, remember that. But the previous pattern is what? A. So A has to be repeated minimum 3 times and maximum 5 times. So B is a part of that string, but B should be followed by A 3 times, 4 times or 5 times, not beyond that. This is what the repetition operator does. Now here is another example for your basic repetition forms. You can go through the formats. In the first format, it says matches previous atom exactly M times, where M is the minimum number of times. Here maximum time is not been specified. So apart from that, the second pattern talks about matches previous atoms M times or more. Okay, so here the N value is not been specified. So minimum number of times the pattern should be matched is given, but how many times the maximum time the pattern should be matched is not been given. So it can match up to N value. So the third pattern, if you look into of the repetition form, it tells that matches previous atom N times or less. So here the minimum times the atom should be matched is not given, but the maximum level at which the pattern should be match is given. So it can be less than n, but not greater than n. You can see with this an example. I have given a pattern CA where I have specified the minimum value that should be matched. Okay, so it will match exactly the minimum value. C is going to be constant, but A has to be repeated minimum 5 times. Okay, so that is what the condition is. So this is the example for the first pattern that I discussed. In the second example is a example for the second pattern where we specify the M value. Okay, but the maximum value is not specified. So here minimum times the pattern A has to be repeated is 3. But it cannot be less than 3, but it can be more than 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on. So, because we have not specified the maximum value of n. Now, the third pattern gives an example of the third example. In this, you can see the minimum number of times the pattern should be repeated is not specified, but the maximum level of pattern that has to be formed is told. So here you can see the maximum times the pattern A has to be repeated is 2 times. So here you can see in the example, you can see A has not appeared. So this is also valid. In the next example, A has appeared 1 time, and in third, A has appeared 2 times. So this is what is the example for basic repetition form. So the next are the example of short form repetition operators. You can see the formats are star plus and question mark. So star indicates a special case matches previous atom 0 or more times. So if I have A star, then it tells that the pattern A can be present 0 or more times in a given string. If I use plus, for example, if I use A plus, then it says that it is a special case which matches previous atom 1 or more times. So plus tells minimum it should appear 1 or more times. Star indicates 0 or more times. So question mark matches previous atom 0 or 1 time only. So remember, question mark is for 0 or 1 time only. Let us look into the example. We have the pattern BA star. So you can see that A can appear, okay, A can appear 0 or more times. Look into the format BA star. So B is going to be there, but A can be repeated 0 or more times. So in the example, you can see B, BA, B double A, B triple A, and B 4A, and so on. Fine. So here you can see that A has appeared 0 times, 1 time, 2 times, and so on. When I say B dot star, okay, it indicates what? The character B can be followed by any character 0 or more times. So in the example, you can see B, there is no character, it can appear. There is A is a single character which is appearing 1 times. Then Z is another character followed by B, it can appear. So and so on. So star dot star. So dot is what? Any character present in that line. Hope you have gone through my previous video. I have explained what is dot operator then. So dot star means 0 or more characters. So there can be no character, or there can be 1 or more characters present in that line. So dot star indicates that. So we have another example, dot plus, that is 1 or more characters. And then in the square bracket, I have mentioned 0 to 9. Okay, which is a class, and it says that the range is from 0 to 9. 0 or 1 digit. So 0 or 1 digit. So either there can be no digit, or there should be at least 1 digit present. So this is an example of your short form repetition operator. So here is another example for repeating pattern matching. So here I have a regular expression BC star D. So what does it say? Okay, star indicates what? 0 or more occurrences of a preceding pattern. Okay, so C can appear more than once. So in a given string A, B, B, C, 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 D, we are going to check whether this pattern given in a regular expression is matching. So we have A, first character in a given string matching with B. So there is no match. Next we go with B. Okay, and in the given regular expression, it is matching with the given string C. Then we move on to match with the next string, that is BC star, which is not matching. Okay, so zero C's are matching. There is no C followed by B, so we don't match it. Next, we move on to match BB with the next character D. So there is no match for D. So we move on to check out with the other thing. So in the last row, you can see we are matching B. B matches. Then you can see there is C star. So B, C star, it is matching, where C is repeating one or more times. So after C, you can find D is also matching. So this pattern successfully match and gives you a correct result. That is, result is true. So this is how normally we represent the various repeating patterns in a given regular expression. Hope you have understood the patterns that we have discussed in today's class, that is the patterns of the operators. So thank you. In the next class, we will be looking into some of the practical aspect and demonstrating the commands of the regular expression that we have discussed in these two classes in the next video. Thank you.